Radiant Team Ban.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back. Welcome to game number 3 of this best of 3, the ESL1 US Qualifier Frankfurt 2016. Everything's on the line. It's a single elimination bracket. There is no second chances, and now Complexity are facing defeat, one of the favorites here in the qualifier, up against enemy GG, who mastered the power of the Ancients to take them out in game number 1 and in game number 2. How's it all go down in game number 3? That's the question I have for you, Heen. The draft's underway, so you got a little bit to work with to answer that question.
Oh, it's kind of interesting that Complexity took two of the heroes from last game away from enemy GG, as enemy started off the draft with the Beastmaster. Probably going to go with something different. Doom already is kind of a slower paced hero. Not terribly ineffective in the early game, but compared to what we saw from them in game 1, for example, they are going to just play out the long term game. Hope to get some farm, and there's that lifestealer again from enemy.
It's back. But how does Complexity deal with it this time? Like, how do you get rid of the pesky Ancient? That's the question.
10 seconds remaining.
A hero that can kill Ancients?
5 seconds remaining.
I'm not sure.
Well, Ursa is normally the best choice. But again, Complexity... Yeah, Ursa is normally the best choice up against the Ancient. But in this case, again, Complexity banned him out. So you got the Doom and the Invoker. The other option is Complexity are just a lot more on point with locking down the Ancient camps. So they understand when the lifesteal is going to rotate off, and they make sure he cannot get an Ancient. That's the other choice.
Reserve time.
I feel like that's going to be kind of hard to do for Complexity, because the Ancients are... at least the first Ancient spawn is going to be there for the lifestealer, and then they will be pretty quick to realize that it's been blocked and it should be an easy D ward.
Yeah. So there's not many other choices you got.
Complexities turn to ban.
Like, you basically need to rake damage into the lifestealer, or you need just a huge amount of physical DPS. Like, that's the way it works.
I don't think they have to mind the lifestealer too much, though. For sure, he was a very big contribution to the team last game, but they were losing in other fronts as well. It's not like just a lifestealer with a Radiance was unkillable and that's why we lost the teamfights. It's more like, oh, we are losing teamfights, and on top of that, we have to deal with the lifestealer. That was the problem for Complexity. So, as long as they know that they are in for a game against the same lifestealer, they should be open to a lot of possibilities. It's just a matter of preference. PL.
Radiant team pick.
I suppose that is the other option too. If, as you're saying, like, Complexity were winning on a lot of other fronts. What if you just take, like, the primary front? Like, you just keep pushing as an insurmountable force that cannot be contested. A black dragon won't be able to do crap against that. And if it's not a direct force, you just have a split force. The Beastmaster was very good at picking out the Nature's Prophet in the last game, but he's gonna have a lot harder time. Like, actually, then again, you could still actually have the NP as the fourth pickup now. It'll be a little bit greedier for Complexity. But they could still do it. But they have better solutions now on the side of Complexity. Escape as well as ability to engage.
I mean, you have to remember that the Lifestealer jumping onto the Ancient is pretty annoying in terms of him being able to scout with impunity, but until he gets that Radiance, at least, he's not going to do too much damage. It's just an Ancient creep walking around, casting spells here and there. They could just go for the approach where they kill everyone else on enemy. Basically, try to win 5-on-4 and leave the Lifestealer for last. Lifestealer really going to do on its own.
Dazzle!
Oh, I want a Dazzle.
Radiant team pick.
Line pickup from enemy GG is just a really nice safe pick. More solid disable. Don't know if they're really too worried about their laning phase. But Dazzle's more of that saving grace. Gives them a lot of armor to work with, able to repair any kind of early burst damage might make it a little bit more difficult as well for Beastmaster to get an instant jump on top of a target.
10 seconds remaining.
Not an instant combo here I look to see him work with though. Like PL Illusions, obviously that's a nice thing to have a heal bomb with.
Turn to ban.
But I'm wondering what Complexity's last support is, or if that's actually going to be a 4-position Doom. So you run Invoker mid, the PL safe lane, a 4-position Doom, and then we just get a Swindle Hero was the last one.
5 seconds remaining.
There isn't too much control from Complexity against the Puck so far. Still need the Doom, especially with Invoker's Deafening Blast no longer being a hard stun. They are going to have quite a hard time killing a Puck who's on point. Possibly, yeah, as you mentioned, some Doom as a 4 position and a hard lockdown offlaner for Swindles.
Yeah. That's what my brain's going at least, but then you're running you're running two supports without any kind of real stuns.
Remaining.
That's the only downside I'm really feeling from that. Like, obviously Doom's got to use Infernal Blade, but...
Reserve time.
Like, it's not some great lockdown control that you're looking for. It's the only thing that makes me question that logic.
This game, they do have the Puck on top of the Lifestealer, one of the classic combos, so... Potentially we're going to see Lifestealer not just on the Ancients, but with the Puck.
Alright, Complexity, give us your last one.
You know what would be funny? Oh, they banned the Chen. But Complexity, take the Chen. Just rush Ags. Steal the creep and send him back home.
That
10 seconds remaining.
Lifesteal would instantly just have to bail out of it.
5 seconds remaining.
That would be one way to deal with him. It's a little bit more clowny, but it would work.
Reserve time.
They'll have to take a different approach. They take out the Broodmother. Like, it stops that strategy I was talking about in game number 2. The Lifestealer takes one lane and then Broodmother goes the other. They are actually running a 4-position Doom. Okay. Darkseer on the lane. A Lifestealer safe lane. Like, I'm actually wondering how effective that's really going to be. Obviously, Feast lets you deal a lot with the harassment that comes out from Darkseer.
Yeah, and occasionally you can just open wounds or creep and regen up, but I think the main strength of the Darkseer against the Lifestealer is not just the laning phase, it's when Lifestealer wants to leave the lane after hitting level 6 and jump on the creeps. Now, you are emptying a lane against the Darkseer, and surely your supports are not going to be able to deal with the Darkseer potentially cutting creeps and losing your tier 1 very early on.
So they can add at least a little bit more pressure. Didn't really think we were going to have a draft today though, where a Nature's Prophet goes completely untouched through the entire draft. Complexity realized they need a different approach to stop that Lifestealer.
10 seconds.
Well, enemy GG. They can run Jungle Heroes of their own? No, they don't need
remaining.
To. Someone that could farm the jungle would be nice, but they go for more of an AoE controller. They bring in the Disruptor. Great up against the Darkseer. Terrific for controlling BLs. If he wants a doppelganger in, that Static Storm's gonna stop him pretty quickly.
Should be pretty hard for Disruptor to land good ults against a PL. Just the fact that when you doppelganger in, he generally has high movement speed, so the kinetic field shouldn't be able to fully form as to keep the PL in, but very good against the Darkseer, good against the Doom. They don't have any obvious BKB carries on Complexity, so if he ever gets into a position where he can Gloomspec the Invoker, that'll almost certainly lead to a kill or a committed teamfight. Swindle's walking to the top lane with this Darkseer. Is this going to be some switch up of the lanes, I wonder?
Looks to be. You got a Doombringer from Z-Freak, so it is going to be a support. So yeah, they run Limp. Hey, how are they gonna do this then? So you roll Chessie into the mid, or you run an offlane Invoker? The PL would normally go mid. Up against the puck, PL also seems to be like a nice little choice. Even if Lance isn't gonna be perfect against the puck, you can still like Phantom Rush into him.
Just switcheroo between the offlane and the safe lane.
Alright, so Limp will stay on the off. It's just because it's also Chessie playing the Invoker now. Well, that's the only thing which is keeping the question mark in my brain.
I always get them mixed up because they're brothers.
That's the end. Yeah.
And if you're gonna scout out this Darkseer and know there's a high chance this Darkseer being in the top lane is gonna be in. It looks like they're gonna dodge the lane from enemy. They quickly realize that it's not the lane, standard lane from Complexity.
The Darkseer is still gonna be fine with this lane. Like, you're going one-on-one up against a Lifestealer. Like, it could definitely be a lot worse.
Early smoke from the two supports on enemy.
Are they gonna get first blood? They may even get the courier if they're lucky. Chessie's having that brought out to him, that's why he's backing up a little bit further. So they won't get the courier, but the smoke will allow them to get closer and closer towards Chessie. And
oh,
they
wow.
Can't get the stun. In fact, Frozen takes a decent amount of damage out from that tower. So, fail smoke gank. And Chessie's gonna happy tree himself back up again from all the damage they did do.
I think the only way that was going to work was if they had gone a bit earlier and Disruptor levels up Glimpse.
They're trying to get the ward to block up that camp. PSJ realized very early on what Swindles was up to when he went off to the side. He's trying to make it really difficult for Swindles to start denying up the creep wave and also just getting some easy quick levels himself. Maybe not the greatest iron shell of Swindles' life, but... because Lifesteal is having a harder time farming when he does that. She's actually using the Iron Shell as well to make sure the Dire Creep Wave pushes in harder.
Mm-hmm. Over at bottom, we're gonna see some action. Heal bomb possibly? Ooh, yep. Hold on. But...
something they may not be expecting is a Doombringer with a Stomp.
Yeah. Enemy don't have any vision around the bottom area. They committed both the ward to the top and the mid lane. So this Doombringer is going to be fairly effective at surprising heroes like the Lion.
This Doombringer is having a great start to the game. Disruptor's gonna have another crack at Chessie in mid. Chessie, he's far enough away. Thought maybe you give it a chance with the Glimpse, but it's still only level 1. This Disruptor's movement into the mid, that's... like this is the second attempt on Chessie's life. I know if he's just trying to zone Chessie out, but with the position of the creep wave too, it doesn't make a lot of sense. Because Chessie's not moving past the stairwell. He's never really had to, the creep wave's always back close towards his own tower. So there's no opportunity.
I think this tends to happen when you're playing Puck against Invoker. You want to use your orb to get the CS and harass against Invoker. So, more often than not, the creep equilibrium is going to be a bit tricky for the enemy supports to gank.
That creep wave also being pulled over to the side means that Frozen's movements to this bottom lane also get scattered out. Limp's trying to keep this creep wave at bay too, so he doesn't lose the momentum of the lane. And here comes your mid gank. Z-Freak rotation over. As just a mini stun, a little bit of chip damage onto Slayer. He already, it's gonna burn his salve. There was a TP coming to mid lane too, but he's got his bottle, so he's perfectly alright with this.
It's more of a harassment. I don't think either side really expected that to lead to anything big.
So, a little bit more of a passive starter to this game. Doesn't really feel like either team is really getting ahead. Like, you got a Doombringer that's getting some good jungle work going on. Most that's still being balanced out by enemy because they're doing some good pulls on the bottom lane to keep their experience coming into the supports. And Lifesteal is getting a lot of farm up on top lane up against the Darkseer. And when you check out the difference between like the Lifestealer and the PL, like Lifesteal's at 25 and PL's at 17. And he's still falling behind. And they are the opposites when you look at them, like they are the one position for their sides. Even if the lines do blur a little bit. This will be an interesting move if Z-Freak can make this work. There's still Rage available for a Lifestealer, so he's going to use it straight away. Infernal Blaze still available to him, Z-Freak. Iron Shell up, another TP support coming over. This time it's going to be the Disruptor who arrives. Z-Freak makes a break for the tree lines. But the Raider will actually creep skip this out, so a fresh Iron Shell is up. There's no Rage available for the Lifestealer, so he's really not ready to go for this fight. And this is what you're talking about with Complexity, where they can just jump between the towers and just keep the creep skip going. And if they're not careful, they're going to lose their courier as well. There's the movement speed away. BSJ getting body blocked up by Z-Freak. Even if Z-Freak's the one caught the Sunstrike, it's going to hit perfectly, and the Lifesteal will burn out to the Infernal Blade. Giving Complexity now, for the first time, maybe they actually lose Z-Freak. On 14 HP, he makes it to the tree line. The wall comes up, he's on the run, the Puck Orb comes from the other direction. Forcing Z-Freak back down to the hands of Frozen. And Swindle's out underneath that tier 1 tower on the top lane, taking more damage.
Nice kill from Complexity as well as a return kill from enemy.
It's all the same to me.
Not yours.
Just after I say, things start slowing down. Pick up the pace.
Yeah, this bottom lane's been quite peaceful after that kill onto Lion. They haven't really found the jump, mainly because Z-Freak has been focusing on the other lanes, but the potential is there. Doom comes in, he lands on Infernal Blade, Lin doppelgangers in, and you have a pretty awesome potential for a good heal bomb. That fresh ward gonna be spotted out from Complexity, so it's never a good feeling to lose your ward within seconds of planning it.
Did the Hulk see it actually go down? Like, if they definitely saw Hanskin move to the side.
Double damage.
Let's just put a Hulk up there instead. It looks like Swindles has actually left the top lane completely. The Lifesteal has already hit level 6, so maybe BSJ is not going to feel as enticed to go directly for the Ancients. The Swindle's TP comes off cooldown. Okay, now he's going to head out to the top lane and start the counter push. While on bottom lane, Lip and Z-Freak now start the creep skipping. Bottom tier 1 tower taking significant damage. The Beastmaster doesn't have his roar just yet, he's short of 5 experience. And that's actually Puck coming down. They're going to try and go for this Dream Coil right on top of the tier 1 tower. Limp will break the tether. The Roar actually pushing Z-Freak into the tree line. He can't even walk himself out this one. With extra stuns, Limp attempting his TP. It will not be in time. They lose both heroes underneath that tower with a great rotation out from Slayer.
My gratitude.
Yeah, I didn't actually know the doppelganger. When you doppelgang out of Dream Coil, you actually get stunned. So that was... Had he not got stunned from Draco, he could have walked out of the roar range, but instant roar. Clean execution from enemy, but the laning stage is still quite static, I feel. It's going to go on for a bit longer than usual. BSJ finally jumps into the Ancient's Greed, but it's blocked. It's
but he can't get out?
Radiance yeah, he's...
This Slayer will help him. He'll take the aggro, but the Ancients have actually dropped him down to like half of his life. That wasn't part of the plan. Small mistakes were made.
The lesson of
but now he goes up to top lane. That's exactly the same build again. And what do you even do against this as a Darkseer? Like, you gotta push the wave so fast that it gets out of the molten fire. That's like the only way you keep your Iron Shell alive, or you put it on yourself.
Slayna is going to be a watch. They're doing exactly the same thing. This dragon, I feel, is pretty much a Darkseer of his own.
He is so much more efficient than a Darkseer, though. He just gets through this so quickly. They have to, like... We haven't seen this abuse in a very long time.
but...
There's gonna be some level of time limit of your infestation.
I mean, I've heard a lot of complaints, suggestions about Invoker, about how he should get nerfed, but... To hear suggestions for how Lifestealer should get nerfed is a first for me, Toby.
Just his infest. Just because it's so douchey. Z-Freak, he's a little bit too deep right now. They send him PL illusions only. Slayer again for his rotation. There's a lot of help coming in. And thanks to Z-Freak's restoration, he may stay alive just in time for the Invoker to Sunstrike down the puck. And now it is enemy who's on the run. One TP out properly, and the Disruptor trying to also leg it. But he'll go down again. Hunskin right behind him. They had so much armor going into that fight thanks to that early weave of Hunskin that the damage from enemy was really minimal. And they try and go for a trade-off. They go for the T1 tower on top, but Chase has got free time to attack into the T1 tower in mid. The T1 tower will also drop the complexity after that successful fight. In fact, it looks like they're going to get both tier 1s as a trade-off for that top tier 1.
Pretty big win for complexity, I think. Even though the Darkseer TP to help his team, his top tower, even though it's going to fall, it's going to come much later than what complexity took the enemy's towers.
Dire's top tower has fallen. It's also the fact that injection of money helps out tremendously for people like Chessy. Example, he is the top net worth right now, finishing under 10 minute Hand of Midas, and already has 1,000 gold again, thanks to the two towers that died after he purchased the Midas.
I just think it's hilarious that Darkseer is the one getting creep skipped on by this Lifestealer.
I still don't think it's even the Lifestealer playing when you look at it this way. Like right now, Lifestealer has converted himself into like Dragon Knight. Like a permanent Dragon Knight.
With a better nuke for farming.
Yep. What do you always want from something like a Dragon Knight? You want the ability to flash farm. How do you do it? Well, I got a bottle, breathe fire. Or I could have a Molten Core. That also functions. And then we have to be a little bit more careful about these fights. Like the Beastmaster wants to engage, but he doesn't have his Necro Book yet. The Invis Rune's going to wear off in a couple of seconds' time, but it's also because Z-Freak has Doom available. So the fighting is a lot more superior. They really don't know about that Observer Ward. Limp gets brought on, Z-Freak, he's waiting for his timing, and now he's wondering, like, do I even Doom here? Yeah, he's going to Doom on the puck. Throw one boulder, he's still got his Splitter Valve, he's trying to wait the time off for the Dream Coil, which is able to do so. They're going to glimpse him back over again. Where's the help? Invoker is just around the corner, but they're trying to Roshan, so Z-Freak is almost a distraction right now. Player's going to come, and he's going to orb into the pit. So while Hanskin and Chessy were trying to get away with a sneaky Roshan, it's enemy who get two kills on practically a core and a half, and stop Roshan from being completed.
Yeah, I didn't even realize they were doing Rosh. It was sort of a slightly slow Rosh, which is why it had to be sneaky. But maybe enemy. Did they have a Hawk there from the beginning?
I don't believe so.
I feel like they moved up. They felt something fishy that there were way too many complexity heroes missing on the map. I mean, there's a skirmish going on. They don't really see any heroes on the map farming. Probably going to be a Rosh.
Slayer still hovering around here just in case. But you notice what enemy have now done. They've practically abandoned every other lane to keep their riots as close as they possibly can on Roshan. But at the same time, Complexity done exactly the same thing. Chasey will go in. They'll try and finish up Roshan. An enemy of the choice now. They try and fight. The Weaver start to prepare itself as well. With the Alacrity buff up on Chasey, a little bit more damage. Slayer coming in very close. The wall is up for Z-Freak. There's no glimpse, there's no combo at all just yet. Lance Harasser from Limp as Swindle really wants to slip in behind. He's got the Mega Bubble in this, but when you get roared up and you're also getting mana burned so heavily by these Necros, he doesn't really have a lot left to fight with. In fact, he's got no life whatsoever. And Chessy, well, yeah, BSJ behind him. Now that Static Storm will split this fight into two. There's still a one-for-one trade-off. Slayer's losing too much life, and he was basically, it was a lesser of two evils here. Who do you really die to? You all the way to one other. Z-Freak will have to just start absorbing up the Necro Books. And Complexity. They will be able to take the engagement and now finish up Roshan.
That was so important for Complexity to win that fight. I felt they committed so many resources to their immediate game plan right now. It's not towers. They took two towers and it was the next one was on the list was Roche.
So
Lifestealer, not too far from his Radiance though. Almighty money. Not sure how much impact it's gonna have in this game because the game is like all three games are going differently in the early game. Game one was kind of a stomp from Complexity in terms of early aggression, and game two was more like enemy took a bit more time than Complexity did in game one, but they started winning team fights convincingly, at least consistently.
I'm wondering if Chessie actually has to build more physical damage just to deal with this, like, Life Stealer. As you said, like, Complexity are getting a lot more money in the early stages of this game compared to game number two of this series. So, is it worthwhile investing that extra cash to make sure you can kill off the Black Dragon once he has the Radiance?
I mean, what could he go, though, on the Invoker? I think he's probably gonna go for normal items, just...
I suppose if you just get the BKB, at least you avoid the miss chance. I mean, there's no reason to build an MKB over an Invoker. But this could work. They're keeping eyes pretty closely with that Dire Observer over on the Black Dragons. With the Lancelord, Beastmaster, he's gonna roar on Swindles. Pushes back a little bit of the Complexity players as four all surrounded. Hunts is gonna keep himself out of that storm and silence himself up here. Shield survived, no he can't. No Shallow Grave in time. As Limp. Now he'll battle in towards the Puck. Slayer's got no way to escape from this, and Chase's got himself a double kill so far. They're still looking for another target, and it's the Lifestealer. He's trying to farm up the Black Dragon and get it up, but you see Z freaking Limp move over. Priority has now just been established.
Oh, he's gonna get doomed.
Oh, oh wow. No! He got in just in the nick of time. But there's three heroes down for enemy. If you wanted a chance to try and pick up that Black Dragon, now would be it. Or you could try and force into the tier 2 tower up on top, which Chessie is already doing. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Yeah, they're actually going to take out the top tier 2 tower as well.
Radiant's didn't even use the Aegis on Chessie, so that's going to mean Invoker is... I think he's going to go for either... Never mind, he's going to go for Blink Tag. I was going to say Boost of Travel or Aghanim Scepter.
I said he wants the maneuverability.
But we are seeing basically what we talked about during the draft, where they don't care too much about the Lifestealer, even with Radiance. He's going to be significantly more annoying, but all they have to do is kill the rest of the team on enemy. It's not like Lifestealer is the greatest hero at cleaning up.
Mm-hmm. Well, looks like they found another target. Top lane. Limp. He tried to doppelganger off the glimpse. Wait, all these storms for that? Okay, that's not so cool. 90 seconds on cooldown for the Disruptor ulti now. Must have actually had that question mark. Does Glimpse actually stop Doppelganger? The answer is no.
Yeah.
I mean yes, because you glimpse.
I think
you get Glimpse back when you Doppelganger.
I think Disruptor was confused as to if like the real peel was still there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
You can understand though, because there were three PLs. But one of them was just the already created illusion. That's where the question mark. Slayer. Up a long way, there's your blink forward. Chessie, not gonna get the call. You didn't want to invoke call snap by the looks of it.
Guardian Greaves complete on Swindles. They were already kind of they secured themselves an upper hand in team fights. They are going to feel pretty damn comfortable with more team fights, and like with the Guardian Greaves on top of the mech, upgraded from the mech.
That Beastmaster got his Necrobook flying out to him. Swindles already turns on the speed.
Oh, the courier.
It's going down. It TP'd out before it delivered its item. Sovereign TP'd out before it delivered its item. It looks like enemy actually will be grouping up for a smoke. They
one
have
interesting
the fresh veil up, ready to go.
Thing that we didn't talk about was the Puck's choice Dyer's to skip Blink Dagger and just go for the Veil of Discord. Dyer's
structures are fortified. It's a nice amplification with the Lion.
And just everyone, basically. even what is it, the Disruptor ulti, the Lifestealer, if he pops out a beast, that's magical damage. And the Radiance too, he does have that Radiance now.
Whole heroes from Complexity run to the mid lane to try and stop the Black Dragon again.
Yeah,
while the rest of enemy are inside the Dire Jungle doing nothing. They're actually running around in circles at the moment.
Enemy, they didn't smoke with ward, so they basically got nothing out of it. They secured themselves a position into the Dire Jungle, but...
Ooh, Swindle's in trouble. He's got no grieve to Babel, and just a quick insurance finger of death coming out from Flying Zebra. Unfortunately for him, he doesn't have an Ancient at the moment. There's only one Ancient Rumblehide that's left just sitting there at the moment. So he can't infest into a great creep straight away. He'll have to wait another 30 seconds or so for it.
Kind of looks like a Slark, now that I look at it.
On top lane, Slayer's down.
Yeah, this I was gonna mention the Shadow Blade pickup on Z-Fing. It's gonna be so annoying for not just the Puck, but anyone to... Like, even the Beastmaster is going to do some split-pushing. Chessy gets caught out in the meantime. I don't know how that happened.
Yeah, I don't know how either. Hanskin's moving over, and... Oh, Hanskin. That was such an easy opportunity as well. I thought he was gonna body block up the camp. And so he lets the Black Dragon spawn up. They should really try and clean that Ancient off. Just to stop the lifesteal. Like, even if it's just for that reason.
I think it's sort of a dangerous position, knowing the enemy are going to prioritize vision over the Ancients to see if it's going to get contested or Complexity are going to drop by and plant a ward. So if PL had gone for the Ancients, he might have been ganked.
Possibly. Like they've walked past at the perfect time where Hanskin could have just like walked maybe a couple of units to the left and blocked it. Just to like delay it, that's all. But now the Black Dragon will assault their own jungle. There is another semi-counter to this. Actually, maybe there's not. Because I figured like, hey, the Forge Spirit's gonna remove off some of the armor, but nope, that doesn't work. You can't mana burn either, because it's a bloody Ancient.
They just have to, there's no easy way around it. Kill the Ancient. After all, it's not doing too much work in teamfights. It's helping enemies secure some map information. Scout out where they are, then his teammates can actually swift push more safely. But a lot of the game right now is going to come down to the next Roshan. Darkseer is very close to his Blink Dagger, and Roche will be spawning within a few minutes.
That's not too far away. Is Slayer not gonna... Okay, it's Zebra's jam, yeah. But he's still so far away from that Blink Dagger. Like, when Lion has a Blink Dagger before you park, you already feel a little unsettled. But Lion's the better initiator at this point in the game. By that Blink into Hex, you're gonna catch any hero you want to.
One thing though is Veil is a pretty nice farming tool for the Puck. Doesn't cost too much mana, you can just spam it on the creeps and shouldn't delay his Blink Dagger by too much. And over the top, I think.
There's your roll. Yeah, if he goes straight to Necros, Chessy gonna try and create a little bit of space with his Call Snap. Blinks up. Z-Freak dropping very low, but the Forge Spirit's army. There's still too much. Z-Freak will just walk himself out. Actually starts his TP as well. Got enough damage, so he'll get away to safety after killing a Beastmaster and burning Necrobook time.
That was a pretty funny sight, that Invoker, even before... I guess he thought the Force Spirits will ensure the kill, but he kind of bailed out, thinking enemy are going to be there to help out his help out their Beastmaster pretty soon.
At this timing, the Force Spirit will see Roshan. Instantly starts attacking it in Complexity. They've still got 10 seconds until Beastmaster is up. So it's a good time to slip inside the pit and take him out. Hanskin will watch him very, very closely. He also, he mismicroed one of the Forge Spirits, is making his way down to the Roshan pit to help out.
Oh, did they not see Complexity walk into the Roche pit? Because it's for the vision right now isn't seeing the right side of entrance to the Roche
pit. Yeah, they wouldn't have seen that. They would have actually seen the Invoker walk up this path because he then blinked from here into the pit. So they wouldn't have seen him come back. They definitely see Z-Freak just patrolling it. But now it's already too late. Invoker is the Aegis Immortal. Yeah, problem with that ward. Didn't realize this stick blocks so much vision. Regeneration.
Puck is very close to that blink dagger, should help their chances in the next teamfight, but at the same time I feel like Complexity still have an edge, simply because they have the Aegis and they never actually fought with the Darkseer's Guardian Greaves in a full-scale teamfight yet. Swindle is actually skipping the blink dagger, just choosing to go with more armor.
Well, does he even need the blink dagger? Because right now, enemy, like, it's pretty obvious when they're going to run at him.
They don't have the best, like, the Darkseer is the Darkseer as a standalone.
He got the Tomb on the Beastmaster, so there's no roar for this fight. Center might be a little bit short, they're trying to get rid of these Necrobooks at the same time. Z-Freak's out of mana, but Lion's out of life. Frozen. Successful TP out, no one will be able to stop him. They're looking for just that quick pick and they're able to get it. A perfect Sunstrike from Chessie, set up by the Observer Ward that was inside the lane. Complexity now, another couple of hero pick-offs, and Swindle stands guard against the Dragon. No more counter pushing.
You know, Swindles wasn't there in the teamfight, but I think one of the reasons that Complexity are able to consistently win these teamfights is the fact that they have so many frontliners right now between the Doom and the PL, and this Invoker with the Aegis is kind of like a pseudo frontliner. And not to mention, Dazzle is backing them up, so if you look at enemies' lineup, they have a Lion. We mentioned the impact that Lion could have with the Blink Dagger, but largely being countered by the fact that whichever target they choose first, they can't expect to actually turn that into a kill, at least not right away. So Complexity are having such an easier time casting their spells in teamfights and not having to worry about any kind of saves from enemy, because enemy actually don't have any utility in terms of counter initiating or canceling out the initiation from.
Yeah, their best defense is offense in this case. Wow. The problem here is like their defense is they're losing so many buildings. Like, you just have to deny your bottom tier 2 tower. But that tier 3 tower on top is also like almost within deny range.
And with the Aegis still pretty fresh on the Invoker, they are going to make more attempts. I think they want to get more out of the Aegis.
There's no Doom available. He'll have to go inside the Granite Column and then just bring it straight back. But can they? Yeah, they're gonna give it a shot. They're gonna try and kill off this Granite Gull before it can reach home. But damn, that's still 2k life to get through in a very short space of time. Just not possible. And the split push begins. Yeah. Again, Complexity. They need that top lane to push in. You still got another just under 2 minutes left on the Aegis the Immortal. Z-Freak's hoping for some kind of opening. The Invoker can just BT down in 20 seconds time.
Yeah, I think Invoker doesn't want to get more farm from the split push. It's more about cleaning up the creep wave so they can actually focus on getting more objectives. However, Complexity are split up right now and enemy are the ones on the hunt for... this is kind of like a cool bait going on with the golems. Hoping he gets gone on like the earlier instances, they can possibly overwhelm Complexity here with the element of surprise.
They managed to find Hanskin. Hanskin's still silent, can't get that Shell of Grave off in time, so he'll go down. But you pick off a Dazzle, and you already have to come back because the pressure the Invoker applied on top. Dyer's
middle tower. Yeah,
like right now, these Forgers may even kill off the tower if they're not mobbed up by Slayer straight away.
And they realize that the Puck TP'd away, so they're just gonna ghost.
Oh, they found their opening. Limp. So low in life, the Grief gives him life, but he can't get back out again. The Life Stealer ensures it, jumping outside of his Infest. But the Beastmaster's life will be taken in trade.
And the Destructor has been pinged out. They know he doesn't have any TPs right now. Oh, wow. He actually gets
But look who else is on the hunt. Z-Freak's coming down. He's gonna run to the left side if he's gonna find Frozen. But it's also during the nighttime phase.
Yeah.
So they're they found the Lifestealer.
This Thunderhide is not that tanky.
And BSJ into Rage. Nice! Stun! Finger! Swindle so low! It's Greaves! He had a half a second left before it was going to come back off cooldown for him. But he was stunned up for that whole duration until death. So he wouldn't have even had a chance to trigger it.
And the good news for enemy is that the Aegis is gone. And they haven't really lost too much since the top tier 3. But it was so low anyway. But the bad news is Chessy has just gold. He has 5k gold. And another thing is that Complexity were able to put some really nice wards into the Radiant Jungle.
With this, enemy can't really move out without Complexity having a good knowledge of it before they leave. Enemy needs something. Like right now, they're 15,000 net worth behind. They're changing the experience up bit by bit, especially getting a couple of those pickoffs. Help them on their way. Yeah, Chessy's getting... he's beyond huge. He's about to finish up an Octarine in 400 gold.
I think the one limiting factor for Complexity or playing more aggressively right now is the fact that PL hasn't been having the best time. He has okay farm. I mean, in terms of net worth, he is 4th out. They have Complexity at 4 out of the 5 top net worth heroes, but he is very vulnerable.
Get a trip call. Phase shift to join himself out. The tornado pretty much on target. And that'll actually cancel off the TP. And Chessy blinks in for the kill as well. Cold Snap was already there, but Slayer. He'll just keep going further in the trees. The orb away. And Chessy gets almost right. That Sunstrike was so close, but it got close enough that Swindles. He doesn't have the damage. The puck will jump again. He goes further north, jumping up through the tree line. And now Hans can. He'll actually phase shift again. They just keep going. The Iron Shell, the back timing. And they pick up the Gem of True Sight, which was in his hands. They'd spent a long time chasing that puck, though.
I think it was definitely worth it, though. They don't really care if the game is stalled a bit. They are in such a demanding position right now. And they get the gem. Now that they've kind of wasted time though, I was thinking they could make a crack at some kind of high ground attempt or a pickoff before the next Roshan, but with the Roshan, third Roshan up so close, they'd most likely just wait it out, play it safe.
Chessy's trying to scout out what the hell enemy are up to. They had the Beastmaster waiting to go in the mid lane, but if the Beastmaster just had a little bit more time to finish up his Blink Dagger, then a mid lane initiation could have been so much more efficient. And now it's the Black Dragon who's on the run. Chessy's doing so much damage with that Alacrity buff up on him, and they surge forward. There it is, with the Disruptor ulti down, it doesn't actually catch anybody. They're gonna glimpse Chessy all the way back, but they use Roar and Glimpse onto an Invoke who's very tanky, taking the Finger of Death, and your Shallow Grave does kick in. Allowing you to fight even harder. A beautiful Dream Coil comes in from the puck for the control. It's really not enough until now. Lifestealer also enters the fray. But Slayer's going down so quickly too, thanks to all the PLs that were there. And we talked about it before, Ancient Thunderhind is not a very tanky Ancient. The Lifestealer does not want to stick around for this. Are they getting a glimpse? Oh, okay, that brings Z-Freak back into the fight. He's a flopping fish. He'll Shadow Blade up. They need the detection, however, they do not see him. And Chessy will create space with the tornado. So Complexity, they'll actually get out of it scot-free after taking two heroes.
Enemy can't catch a break. I thought that might lead to a kill on the Doom, but having no true sight. Oh man. After that engagement, I think third Roche is almost guaranteed to go to Complexity.
They're still a little bit away, but it would take a miracle from enemy. Like, all your lanes have to push out. At least one of those Observer Wards is going to time out before Roshan spawns. So Complexity won't see as much. And actually just, they just buy a gem. Lifestealer just put his Tranquil Boots on the ground, so you'll be able to carry the gem.
Yeah.
I suppose he doesn't really care. He's still the Ancient Black Dragon, so why you need movement speed?
He does get faster with the Tranquil Blue. The problem for enemy right now is that their top net worth, the only one who's actually staying competitive with complexity, is the Lifestealer. And we're 34 minutes into the game, and if this Lifestealer is not going to feel comfortable fighting as a normal hero, and he's just rather going to be inside the Ancients, that's not a big difference from what he can do at, let's say, the 20 minute mark, even the 10 minute mark, when it's not a big difference. He basically has Radiance on an Ancient Creep.
Is it actually worth him coming out just so you have open wounds? And obviously, like, Rage is an advantage, but is it just worth it for the open wounds for the rest of your team?
I don't think open wounds is not a very good skill against what Complexity have right now. They have the Guardian Greaves on Darkseer, PPL's gonna doppelganger out of it. It's a great spell if you can make use of it, but it's just hard to make use of it for enemy.
Look at Complexity go. They're gonna see a Courier for a moment, which is actually picking up the Tranquil Boots finally, and they're like, okay. Tranquil Boots flying over in this said direction towards the Ancient Black Dragon. But Complexity had the lane with them, and all they gotta do is have that lane go through the mid, and they can rotate up towards the top if they want to, and just focus on the right. Instead, they go for the tower, they get the fortification out, and enemy had to TP back one by one.
I think enemy didn't. They expected Complexity to make some kind of play into the Roche pit.
Seafreak. He got out of the kinetic field.
He has a BKB, so for the next fight, he's going to be pretty damn hard to control.
Slayer, he's actually going to go into this one. The Ancient Granite Golem is not looking too healthy. There's your war over on Z-Freak. They really want to bring down this Doombringer, but the Shallow Grave from Hanskin. He just sits on the back line. He dooms up the Lifestealer. You've lost two heroes, and this could just be the disaster that enemy have been avoiding for so damn long. They got perfectly backwalled up by Swindles. There goes four heroes down, and it's probably going to be five. Slayer on the run. He was elusive previously, but if he wants to be elusive this time around, no. EMP Tornado can hit pretty well until the Yulstifter just screws it up a little bit more. And then lose the Radiant Courier. And they're probably going to lose... Nope, Tuck stays alive. But they're going to lose the Rax. Probably two lanes as well. Radiant's middle tower
has fallen. I think this is game, honestly. They kind of hit their peak as for the lineup. Lifestealer wasn't going to progress that much further.
It's just crazy to think like how close Complexity did come to like losing this series. There's the GG.
I mean, in this particular game, they were under no danger of being behind. It felt like they were consistently ahead in this game. But they did have an answer for Lifestealer, it seems, is to kind of ignore the Lifestealer. They didn't really pick a hero that is going to kill the Ancients. They just... it's annoying and frustrating that the Lifestealer is running around, just cutting creeps here and there, but this is kind of what happens when you all